Hey friends, debugging network issues across layers can be complicated. Network Insights gives you a comprehensive view of health and metrics for all your deployed network resources without requiring any additional configuration. Dalan Mendonca is here to show me how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Dalan who's going to talk to me about Network Insights. How are you?
I'm good, Scott. How are you?
I'm lovely, and I'm thrilled to talk to you because I'm going to learn new things about the unified network monitoring experience available in Azure. So what's the problem? What is the problem that people who have complicated networks that need to troubleshoot and monitor in Azure?
So when you think about network monitoring, customers are faced with a plethora of tools and solutions that they need to look at to find out where the exact root causes. So if I may share my slides here.
Please.
So when customers look at their network monitoring tool chain, they have a plethora of tools at their disposal. Things customers are interested in are health monitoring, what is the health of my resource, the metrics, the alerts. For that, they have Azure Monitor. They have various networking resource plates that they can go and find out metrics or look at logs. Next up, for customers who are interested in end-to-end connectivity, this is the space of installing agents and doing threat tests across your hybrid network. You have Connection Monitor. Finally, you have traffic for traffic monitoring, where typically customers want to know what is hogging up my bandwidth. They want to store logs for audit and compliance. There we have network energy flow logs and traffic analytics. And finally, we have a whole set of tools for checking the state of your network, say IP flow verify, which is to verify NSGs are configured correctly, or packet captures to check the state of your network troubleshooting. Now, working across all these tools can become a real pain, especially when you're debugging a live site issue. You have to jump from tool to tool. You scramble across a variety of tool chains. When we face this problem, we built Network Insights as a single network monitoring hub where customers can come in, so one-stop solution for network monitoring. Now what does Network Insights bring to the table? In Network Insights, customers get a single health metric and alert console. They don't have to look in five different places to find alerts. Now, Network Insights is available out of the box with zero configuration. Customers are wary of installing agents to get signals, but Network Insights is available without any agent or configuration. It's ready to go from day one. Customers can now search for resource properties and associate resources. What does that mean? Now, for example, the performance of a load balancer is not just dependent on the load balancer itself. If the load balancer is connected to a backend PMSS or a VM, at the front end, it has a public IP. If any of these resources faces an issue, your load balancer performance will be affected. In Network Insights, we've made a way for you to drill down from an alert to the load balancer and to the connected resources and find out the exact root cause. And this is enabled by what we call the dependency view, where, as you can see on screen, it shows all the connected resources and an under-the-hood view of the resource.
One of the things that I noticed there that's so significant is this idea of no agent configuration. I think a lot of people assume they have to install things, but this is the magic of software-based networking, isn't it? You've been able to enable this Network Insights for everyone automatically, so I don't have to push any buttons, install anything, or check any boxes to make this happen.
Yes. So Network Insights not only incorporates out-of-the-box signals from you will get health metrics alerts for your networking resources, but of course there are customers who also want to do configuration-based monitoring. They want to log their traffic. They want to set up alerts. They want to specifically monitor connectivity from point A to point B. Mm-hmm. Network Insights also incorporates those signals into one place. So if you want out-of-the-box solutions, you have it ready. If you want to set up advanced telemetry tests that are bespoke to your network, those two are aggregated and available inside Network Insights.
Very cool. So what does it look like in the Azure portal?
Well, let's begin with the demo. Yeah. So what we're seeing on screen is the Network Insights tab in Azure Monitor. It's available right inside Azure Monitor, not a new experience, not a new thing you have to learn. What you're seeing on the screen and what you can see here is three different tabs here: Network Health, Connectivity, and Traffic. So let's talk about the Network Health tab, which is available out of the box without any configuration. As you can see here, this is a health gallery of all the networking resources that are available. You have application gateways, ER and VPN connections, extra service circuits, and more. So right away, I can at a glance know what is the health of my network. As I can see here, some of these bars are green. I can see all my network application gateways are performing well. On the other hand, I can see that some of my express out circuits are showing red. There's a health issue there. So this allows me quickly to start thinking about, hey, where might a problem be, and start drilling down and looking for issues. Now, the first thing a customer will do when they come here is that they will want to debug further. So let's see, if I click on application gateway, I suspect an issue there. So I get this drill down of all the application gateways that are in my network. Here, immediately, I can see this entire list of application gateways. I can see critical metrics right up front. So for an application gateway, you typically want to know your throughput, your response status on the backends, failed requests, if any, and the unhealthy host count from the backend. So right at my fingertips, I have these metrics available. Now, it just doesn't stop there. If you want to debug an application gateway, you can click on this icon on the left, which opens up the dependency view. Now, what is the dependency view? I've clicked through the dependency view. Now, this dependency view is an under-the-hood look at a particular resource. Now, this is the dependency view for an application gateway called Canary Net3 App Gateway. At the front end, you can see the front end IP configuration. You can see the listeners, the rules. And finally, you can see the backend VMs and VMSs that it's connected to. So it's not just about the resource. It's also the resource that it's connected to that you need to look at when you want to debug a resource. And all of these are available here. Now, right away in the visualization, I can see how my backend VMs are unhealthy. This immediately tells me in a very visual and intuitive fashion that, hey, this is where the problem is and I can debug here. So I can click through, repair that VM, and then my application gateway will be healthy again. So we are building these topologies for all resources. Similarly, we have an example would be, now that application gateway was a single resource, we've also built similar topologies for virtual VANs, which is a resource, connectivity across regions and clouds. So you can see here how one VLAN is represented by multiple firewall virtual hubs. You have your connections, you have your on-prem sites. And in this case, all of them are healthy. So this allows me to, at a glance, know what is the health of not just a resource, but also the various resources connected to it. Now, along with the functional topologies that we presented, if I want to know the root cause, I have at my disposal metric workbooks that we've pre-built and made available to customers. Now, normally these metrics are available to customers, but they have to write queries, they have to configure dashboards, and author workbooks by themselves. So we've gone a step ahead and made it accessible for them from the get-go. So right here in the application gateway workbook, you can see there's the status of the application gateway. You can see unhealthy hosts at the backend. You can look at throughput, current connections, CPU utilizations, all typical metrics that someone who's debugging an application gateway would be interested in. We've provided information about every metric and grouped metrics by various tags. So you have performance, latency, traffic, backend billing.
Can I ask a quick question?
Yeah, sure.
So this notion of unhealthy, is unhealthy something that is understood? It's just that it's unavailable? Is it missed a ping? What is unhealthy in the context of some of these network devices?
So every resource defines its health differently, but they emit what is called a resource health check. In the case of VMs, I think it's more closer to whether the VM is responding provisioned well or it's not responding to ARG.
Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. Thank you.
So you have a variety of resources available and metrics available. You can group and ready for you to go. And you with zero config, you have this deep look where you can explore all of these metrics and find out the root cause of any issue, and without learning how to set up your dashboards or any metrics at all. Going forward, we also have, so the next tab in Network Insights is the connectivity tab. As I mentioned, for customers who are looking for connection configuration based monitoring, where they want to set up agents, they want to set up tests across their network and check connectivity and reachability. That data is typically available in Connection Monitor, but we've aggregated that and shown it here. What you're seeing on screen is a set of tests where the sources are virtual machines and the destinations are virtual machines or URLs. I've already filtered it. So this allows me to view all the tests and their statuses. You can immediately see the reachability status, what test is running, which port is it talking to. And at an instant glance, I can see what is the state of my network, how is connectivity across it. Should there be an issue here, I will immediately see my test turning red. I can click through and explore further. What does that look like? So let me just explore these. Yeah. So this is the data from Connection Monitor. We are getting the checks fail percentage. We're getting what was the source and the destination of this particular connectivity test. And if I click through on it, I can see it helps me debug the issue. As I can see here, it tells me the exact NSG rule that was causing this connectivity issue. So right away, I can pinpoint to a particular root cause and understand why my connectivity test was failing. So that is the experience on the connectivity tab. Finally, we have the traffic tab. The traffic tab is oriented around helping customers understand their traffic monitoring coverage. So two of our solutions are for traffic monitoring are NSG flow logs and traffic analytics. Here you can see where you have enabled traffic monitoring, which is by enabling NSG flow logs and traffic analytics. And if you want, you can drill down to any particular region, see your list of NSGs, and enable or disable traffic monitoring on them. This is a single glance view to understand your traffic monitoring coverage.
How did people do this before? Did they just run their own runbooks, create their own runbooks, run around in multiple places, four different places to find this information?
So the data, so every tab that we are talking about here in Network Insights is actually an independent product and experience in itself. So if I just start with Network Health, it's available as a signal which you can set alerts on. The metrics are available, but they're available only after you query them. You have to go specifically to every resource, write a query, or configure some charts and pin them to a dashboard, and then they're available. Or you can alternately configure workbooks. So it took a lot of help. You have to go through that learning curve and then discover these metrics, but which are very essential to your understanding of the resource itself. So we've gone ahead and created these pre-built workbooks for customers to quickly discover this automatically. Now, if I talk about connectivity and traffic, both of these solutions existed independently, but now they were two independent solutions. They were not available in the context of Azure Monitor. They were not aggregated together. So we're bringing all of that experience together in Network Insights. So any issue of your network, any part facing troubles, any signal is going to be aggregated here. Yeah.
Wow, that's fantastic. So this is one centralized console for network monitoring, for troubleshooting. I really was impressed with the creation of those topologies. I don't have to draw those diagrams. Those are created for me by looking at my own network.
Yep. So the topologies really enable you to visually debug. So instead of so typically the flow that would happen before this was that if I go back to the example of the load balancer, would be, okay, you get an alert saying my load balancer is unhealthy. You'll debug it and you're looking at your flows through it and you say, okay, it looks fine. Where could the issue be? Oh, it could be one of my backend VMSSs, or it could be my frontend IP. Now I'll branch out and I'll be debugging both of those and come back. So we've tried to streamline that process, show all of this together, show all of them connected together and show the health right away. And so that you don't have to do all this manual debugging and you can just visually and very intuitively understand, find the root causes out.
Fantastic. So this is available today. I have this. Like, I can hang up the phone with you right now, go to Azure, and I'm going to discover this. I've already got this available, and customers can start monitoring right away.
Absolutely. It's available. It's GA'd since December 2020. It's available right away in the portal, and zero configuration needed. Just click through, and you're done.
That's fantastic. And this is going to be continually updated with new views and new signals and new insights. And I understand that if you click on feedback, it goes to real human beings like yourself. And the team does read the feedback and is always improving Network Insights.
Absolutely. So two things I'd like to call out here is that we didn't want to create another tool that tries to become the tool that solves all tools. This Network Insights is available right inside Azure Monitor. It's the Network Insights tab over there. Mm-hmm. And you can switch context seamlessly from application monitoring or debugging to network monitoring and debugging. So no new tool to learn. This works with the workbooks framework that's already existing for Azure Monitor in general. And yes, we will be continuously adding new topologies and new signals. And that's where we want customer feedback. Any gaps that you highlight, any monitoring signals that you want, or any feedback for the tool, we'd like to hear from you. And yeah, we're all yours.
Fantastic. This is great. Thank you so much for spending time with me today.
Thank you so much, Scott. It was great talking to you.
All right. I am learning all about the great new unified network monitoring experience, Network Insights, inside Azure Monitor today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.